There were once fishermen who spent their entire lives on the waves, catching fish and watching the rhythms of the sea, amid the wide expanse of the Pacific Ocean. One day, they became aware of something out of the ordinary. The water was warmer than usual, and odd things were occurring in the currents. They had never seen anything like this before. They started to see a trend when they discussed their observations with others. Every year around Christmas, this strange occurrence would take place. They referred to it as El Niño, which is Spanish for little boy or Christ child. Since it provided warmth to the chilly waters during the winter, they thought this phenomenon was a gift from God. El Niño was part of a bigger cycle of marine and atmospheric changes that had a significant impact on weather patterns all around the world as scientists started to investigate this phenomenon over time. The World Meteorological Organization predicted 2 weeks ago that El Niño and climate change will result in very severe global warming over the next 5 years. Although it's still not definite, it is now more likely than ever that El Niño and heat-trapping greenhouse gases will cause the Earth to warm to record highs within the next 5 years. Health, food safety, water management, and the environment would all suffer as a result, and this may happen as soon as 2024. It's important that we should be ready. It all began with anchovies. Anchovies are in the ocean before they end up on our pizza or in a tin container with a rollaway lid. In the 1960s, Wright Pennsylvania boats used to return to shore every day, laden with thousands of anchovies. This was a blessing for those who had difficulty farming the land due to the arid environment near Peru and Ecuador's coasts. They relied heavily on those anchovies as a source of food and revenue. But in 1972, everyone was dismayed when the fishermen brought their empty nets back. The seabirds, which typically dined on the anchovies, were going hungry and dying. The fishermen observed an odd thing. There were no anchovies despite the water being warmer than usual and the appearance of other fish. The air was humid rather than dry, and the skies were gloomy and cloudy. The locals there gave this occurrence, which would reoccur every few years, a name, El Niño. Today we are aware that El Niño is a crucial component of the ENSO, or El Niño Southern Oscillation weather phenomenon, and it impacts the entire planet, not just the fish in Peru. Knowing the causes of the anchovy deaths will help us better grasp what El Niño is and how it affects the planet. Consider yourself a tiny anchovy swimming in the ocean on the Peruvian coast. Because the water is nutrient-rich and chilly, life is good. This is due to a mechanism known as upwelling, which functions as a kind of elevator for water from the ocean's depths. As you can see, winds from the north drive the surface water away from the coast along South America's west coast. This makes room for the deep water's nutrient-rich surface to rise up and feed the hungry phytoplankton. Additionally, zooplankton can be found anywhere phytoplankton is present, and anchovies can eat zooplankton. But occasionally, something called El Niño occurs. This is similar to an ocean temper tantrum brought on by alterations in the wind patterns. El Niño causes upwelling to slow down, which causes the anchovies to become perplexed, like lost fish in an unsure sea. Fishermen attempt to catch them in the customary locations, but no fish are present. This is bad news for us humans, who appreciate a delicious anchovy pizza or Caesar salad because it implies there will be less fish available for consumption. It's crucial to comprehend why anchovies disappear during El Niño, since it sheds light on how our world functions in general. Small adjustments can have large effects elsewhere in the world, just like a small shift in the wind can have an impact on the ocean. It's similar to the game of Jenga, in that one brick removed can cause the entire tower to collapse. So let's be aware of what we can do and how it affects the environment. It is easy to draw conclusions about what El Niño actually is. It is an oscillation of the ocean atmosphere system in the tropical Pacific, having important consequences for weather around the globe. The equatorial Pacific's exceptionally warm ocean temperatures are what define this phenomenon. As shown in Australia, the warming of the ocean can result in deadly bushfires as well as disastrous floods. El Niño is extensively watched since it is crucial for the forecasting of sudden changes in the climate. Weak El Niño conditions and cooler than average water temperatures in the eastern Indian Ocean led to bushfires in Australia during the black summer of 2019 to 2020. These circumstances, which frequently but not always coincide with El Nino, encourage drier weather in the southern and eastern regions of the nation. Having said that, the World Meteorological Organization, WMO, just issued a bold and alarming statement regarding the future of our planet. Within the next 5 years, it's likely that El Nino and human-caused climate change will cause global temperatures to reach record highs. According to the WMO assessment, there is a 66% possibility that between 2023 and 2027, global temperatures will be at least 1.5 degrees higher than pre-industrial levels for 1 year. Furthermore, there is a 98% possibility that one or more of those 5 years will set a new record for warmth. It makes sense to assume that this will occur in 2024. Despite the fact that El Nino is a natural occurrence, it is predicted to cause global temperatures to rise in the upcoming months, with uncertain effects on the environment, water management, food safety, and health. The WMO Secretary General, Petteri Tallas, says we need to get ready for the effects of this hazardous combination. Furthermore, over the next 5 prolonged Northern Hemisphere winters, Arctic warming is expected to be 3 times greater than the estimated global anomaly compared to the average of the years of 1991 to 2020. The report also predicts a change in precipitation patterns, with more rain falling in certain places and less falling in others. Higher ocean acidity levels, melting glaciers and sea ice, rising sea levels, and more extreme weather patterns are some of the effects of human-induced greenhouse gases. The Paris Agreement placed a strong emphasis on the need for all countries to considerably decrease their greenhouse gas emissions in order to keep global temperatures from exceeding 2 degrees Celsius, with additional measures to keep it below 1.5 degrees Celsius. If global warming exceeds 1.5 degrees Celsius, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change warns climate-related dangers would increase, necessitating immediate action to lessen these negative effects. To guarantee a sustainable future for our world, we must give climate action top priority. It's not all bad news, however. Although El Nino poses a great threat, he is not the only player in the game. The equatorial Pacific experiences extremely chilly ocean temperatures during La Niña, which also exists. La Niña has the opposite impact of El Nino and can boost rainfall in areas that are prone to dryness. El Nino may inflict some harm, but it's not all terrible news. We can prepare for its effects and foresee its occurrence. In a similar vein, El Nino alleviates drought conditions and can provide populations impacted by El Nino with a much-needed break. Although we should approach these meteorological events with respect and prudence, we shouldn't overreact. One must first look closely at the typical state of the Pacific Ocean affected by ENSO in order to fully understand the cause of El Nino. The trade wind system in this area, which is in charge of the dominant winds, is very important in the development of El Nino. The doldrums are a region of low pressure close to the equator. The horse latitudes, in contrast, are the names given to the main high-pressure systems that can be found 30 degrees north and south of the equator. The Western Pacific's tropic zones are warmed unevenly by the sun, which causes the air to rise into the atmosphere. When this hot air reaches the equator on its journey to the doldrums, the Coriolis effect causes it to be redirected westward. The Coriolis force is a second acceleration that affects how objects move in a rotating system, such as Earth. This is crucial in figuring out which way the trade winds will blow. The northeast and southeast trade winds, which bear the names of their points of origin, are created as a result of the Coriolis effect. The typical trade wind system, which pushes air westward over the Pacific equator, is formed when these winds combine. Additionally, these winds produce gyres, which are huge ocean currents that move surface water in a westward direction and are sustained by the prevailing winds. The water depths change as a result of this. Upwelling is the process of cooler subsurface water replacing warmer subsurface water as it travels west. In the Western Pacific, where warm surface water has accumulated into a warm pool, the sea level is typically half a meter lower than in its Eastern Pacific at the equator. Due to the upwelling of these cooler surface waters, the sea temperatures in the west are frequently 8 degrees Celsius higher than those in the east towards South America. Due to the moisture in the winds as they travel over the Pacific, the dominant winds also contribute to heavy rainfalls over Southeast Asia and Indonesia. This entire system changes during El Nino, having an effect on the ecosystem on a large scale. Oh hey, if you're still here, it means you're really enjoying this video. Why didn't you press the like button? It would help us a lot. Thank you. Here is a helpful overview if you're curious about how El Nino may impact your region. El Nino rules over the enormous expanse of South America, tossing caution to the wind and upsetting the continent's weather patterns. The normally barren and lonely western coast of South America experiences exceptional excessive rainfall, which causes floods of devastating proportions. This phenomenon is brought on by the warming of the Pacific Ocean's subsurface waters, which cause the ocean's oxygen content to drop. Fish become scarce as a result, which has negative economic effects, especially in Peru and Ecuador. During the summer, the eastern part of South America, which includes nations like Brazil and Argentina, experiences an increase in atmospheric humidity. On the other hand, the winters are moderate and don't typically bring heavy snowfall. Dependent on latitude, El Nino behaves differently throughout North America. On occasion, intense downpours in the Caribbean and the southern United States completely wreak havoc. The warming of the surface water causes milder winters and springs with greater temperatures as one proceeds further north, from Oregon to Alaska. Moving on, El Nino causes drought-like conditions in Australia and southern Polynesia, significantly lowering rainfall levels. Typical cyclone activity is on the rise in several archipelagos, including Tahiti and Hawaii, as a result of El Nino. Warmth surrounds Japan and Korea, resulting in muggy summers and pleasant winters. Southern Asia, which stretches from Indonesia to India, is less fortunate since the rise in temperature is followed by a sharp decline in rainfall, which causes severe droughts that can continue for years. In Africa, the southeastern region of the continent, which is devastated by droughts and higher temperatures, is where El Nino's effects are most notable. However, rainfall in the Horn of Africa increases. The repercussions of El Nino in Europe are still not fully understood. They have a shorter impact and are less harsh. So, we have a basic understanding of what El Nino is and how it affects the world. However, the Earth's rotation rate change is arguably one of its most intriguing impacts. This is how it works. Imagine the Earth to be a skater whirling on ice. The skater speeds up their spin by bringing their arms closer to their bodies as they turn. This is due to the requirement of the conservation of angular momentum, that the skater's rate of rotation rises as their arm radius falls. Similar to this, when there is an El Nino, the wind patterns in the Earth's atmosphere alter, which causes the distribution of mass on the planet to change. The total angular momentum is conserved through a reduction in the rate of rotation of the Earth. Even a little change in the Earth's rotation can have significant effects, such as affecting weather patterns and raising or lowering the sea level. This change may appear insignificant. The Earth can thus alter its rate of rotation to take account of variations in the atmosphere, just like a figure skater. We continue to track and research El Nino in order to forecast worldwide weather patterns and comprehend how climate change is affecting our globe. So keep in mind the tale of how the lives of anchovies and people in Peru are strongly related to the El Nino Southern Oscillation the next time you order a pizza with anchovies or open up a tin can with a rollaway lid. Thanks for watching. What are your thoughts about El Nino? Let us know in the comments below.